Hello students, today we will start teaching aptitude and our target is JRF June 2019. Here we will cover 10 questions on teaching aptitude. So let's begin. Question 1. Effectiveness of teaching has to be judged in terms of course coverage, students' interest, learning outcomes of students, use of teaching aids in classroom. So here you have to choose the most appropriate option. So most appropriate option is learning outcome of students. Why? Because our target is not to just cover the course, not only students' interest, not only use teaching aids in the classroom. Our main motive is the final learning outcomes of the students. Question 2. Which of the following statements are correct about deemed universities? Option 1. The governor of state is the chancellor of deemed university. They can design their own syllabus and coursework. They can frame their own guidelines regarding admission and fees. They can grant degrees. So, our right option is B, C and D. Why B, C and D? Because they have the power to make their own syllabus, to frame their own guidelines regarding admission and fees. They can grant their own degrees, but the governor of state is not the chancellor of deemed university. In which of the following teaching method, learners' participation is made optimal and proactive? So here, you will confuse in discussion and project method. But our right answer is project method. Why project method? Because in project method, every kind of learner takes part in it. But in discussion method, an introvert student will not take part. I hope you will understand this question. The most important task of teaching is make monthly reports and maintaining records, make assignments and hearing recitations, directing students in the development of experience, or none of these. So here, our right answer is directing students in the development of experience. Why? Because our target is not to make only reports and assignments, but direct the students in the development of experience. The most accurate statement about teaching machines is that A. B.F. Skinner began the movement for their use. They were designed as an economy measure to replace teachers. They are not as efficient as teachers in reinforcing responses. They can be used for all learning programs. So here, our right answer is B.F. Skinner began the movement for their use. You have to learn this question as it is very important. Why should a student not be punished severely? First, he may quarrel with a teacher. He may leave the school and join another. His parent may quarrel with the teacher. The student may develop a negative attitude towards his studies, teacher and school. So you know very well, if a student will be punished severely, he will develop a negative attitude towards his studies, teacher and school. The term least restrictive environment refers to education of the. So here, least restrictive environment is followed for handicapped students. A newcomer teacher who is maltreated in his class will deal with the students by: will he apply punitive measures, or he will improve his qualities and expressing it before them in a good way, changing his class after consultation, giving them a threat of expulsion. Here our right answer is, he will not adopt any negative measure. He will adopt a particular measure, that is improving his qualities and expressing them in a good way. There are so many definitions of learning. Which of the following is most adequate? So here you have to choose the most appropriate option. The modification of behavior, the development of skills, the acquisition and organization of knowledge, all of these. So here our right answer is modification of behavior. Why modification of behavior? Yes, it is true that in learning there is a development of skills There is acquisition and organization of knowledge, but the most important part of learning is the modification of behavior of students. If majority of students in your class is weak, you should not take care about intelligent students. Keep your speed so fast so that students' comprehension level may increase. Keep your teaching slow, which can also be helpful to bright students. Keep your teaching slow along with some extra guidance to bright people. So here our right answer is D, that is keep your teaching slow along with some extra guidance to bright people. Why? Because we have to take care all kind of students, whether they are weak or intelligent. So thank you so much, friends. I hope you will like this video. Thank you so much.